For those of you who are new here, my name is Ivan, and I take your tech questions and give you back plain answers. So with that, let me go ahead and jump onto my iPhone and open the Photos app. So I'm not going to cover how the Photos app works here. If you're interested in that, I'll drop a link in the description to my video from last week, and you can check it out there. This time, I'm going to tap on search, and I'm going to search for the word zoo, because I'm interested in creating a photo slideshow that includes photos and videos from previous zoo trips that I've taken with my family. So I'm going to select and pick a couple of videos, a couple of photos, and I can include both videos and photos, or any combination, just photos or whatever. So I'm going to go ahead and select a few items here that are visually different maybe from one another. And then once I've chosen the items I'd like to include, I'm going to tap the menu button, the ellipsis here, and choose play a slideshow. Once I tap play a slideshow, it's going to start the slideshow presentation. I'll tap once to get controls, and then I'll tap here to pause. And I just want to show you that there are some controls here. You got close, mute, which really silences the presentation but doesn't remove the music. You've got share, and you've got a menu of different choices that are available. As soon as you make any kind of edit to your slideshow, it'll be saved into the memories area of the Photos app. And that's what I recommend. Before you get in and start making all of your customizations, I recommend editing at least the title so that it gets saved into the memory section, and then close the presentation here and go open it in the memories section. I'll show you that right now. So I'm going to edit the title. It gets added to memories. I'm going to call this Zoo Trip. And I have an option to add more photos if I'd like. I've already selected the photos that I want, so I'm going to go ahead and tap done. And now I'm going to close this slideshow, tap done, and scroll down to the memories section. And you can see here, there's the zoo trip that we just created. So I'm going to tap on that and then tap once to get controls and tap to pause again. And I want to show you that the controls are in a little bit of a different arrangement this time. Apple has unified the slideshow experience. So no matter how you create a slideshow, once it shows up under memories and you open it, you'll see all of these same options here. So the comment that I'm showing on the screen right now asked, how do you remove audio from a slideshow? I was under the misimpression that just pressing the mute button would allow you to remove the music from your slideshow, but it doesn't do that. What it does instead is it just silences the music for you. And when you share it, the person on the other side receives the presentation with the music intact. So let me show you right here. This is where you can edit the music. And if I tap on this, you'll see that it shows me the track that's currently selected. I can tap here to choose a different track. And if I choose something that's copy protected, like so, that song gets placed in this presentation. The problem that I have, though, is if I elect to share this with someone and the song that I've chosen is copy protected, I'll be asked to use a shareable track, which is a track that has fewer restrictions on it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Choose shareable track. I'll choose one of these dreamy tracks. At present, there's no way to remove audio from a slideshow. I called Apple and I talked with them about this. And what I'll do is I'll drop a link in the description to a place where you can submit feedback if you would like to have the option to remove music from your slideshow presentation so they can play silently. Let's take a look at what are the options here. So we've got the mute, unmute. We've got a menu, which we'll come back to in a moment. The X for close. Down here, we took a look at music just a second ago, but you'll see next to that, we have these overlapping circles, which are the memory looks. So you can apply essentially like a filter or a color style to your videos if you like. I'm not going to do that this time. And that's everything about music. Let's go ahead and go back. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to pause again. So you've got thumbnails to jump around your slideshow to take a look at how things are. We've also got the ability up here to edit a few things. So we're going to tap menu, and you can show a map, which will show you a map of where the different photos were that are included in the slideshow, where they were taken. If you have your location services turned on when you do that, we can do edit movie timeline, which allows us to see a thumbnail representation of all of the images and videos in our slideshow. We can move them around to reorganize them. Let's go back. You can tap the menu here and you can edit the movie title like we did earlier. You can hide the preview, add to favorites. You can choose, oh, this photo is more representative of the zoo than my first photo. So let me make this the key photo so that whenever I look at the zoo trip and it starts from the beginning, that's the slide that shows first. And then you have the option to airplay the movie or to loop. Honestly, for me, mostly what I'm doing is I'm editing the title. I might rearrange the order of the photos, and I may put it on loop so that if I just airplay from my phone, the presentation goes over and over and over again without me having to export it elsewhere. So let me go ahead and share this video, because I got to thinking, what else do we want to know about these videos? So we can't remove the music. What happens when we share it? So when I go to share, I can send it by messages, I can send it by email, I can save it to my library as a video item in my library, or what I'm going to do is save it to files, because I want to show you information about the file that gets created when you export your slideshow this way. So let's go ahead and tap save, and then I'm going to tap out of here and go into files so that I can show you. There's my zoo trip right now, and I'm going to get info on this so I can show you that when you create a slideshow presentation on your phone and you share it out, it is a movie file, an MOV file, QuickTime. It's also using 1080p resolution. That's 1920 by 1080. And this is important because if you have a modern iPhone, you're probably taking 12 megapixel or 24 megapixel photos and maybe 4K videos. But a 1080p video is roughly 2.2 megapixels. I think that's right. Let me know if I got it wrong in the comments. But essentially, there's a big difference between 12 megapixel and 2 megapixel. There is a trade-off for this. So what you're getting, the part that you benefit from, is you get a smaller video that's easier to share with folks. The compromise is that because the quality of the video is getting reduced so much, if you do present this slideshow on a large screen, you might notice that the final presentation is a little blurrier, not quite as detailed as the original. And that's to be expected because whatever your original file size is getting squeezed down to a smaller file format, more than likely 1080p. If you have an older iPhone or if you're on an older iOS, like an iOS 17, these slideshow presentations were produced at 720p. For most of us, I don't think most of us really notice. Most of us probably won't care. It only makes a big deal if you're on a large screen and you're trying to see the highest quality possible. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and tap done here. I'm going to jump out of here and I'm going to say, if you have any tech questions, drop them in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.